Also, I am filming on my phone because this is how long I've not filmed for. I know this camera was dead. Turns out it is. How annoying. Hi guys, it's Sarah and welcome back to another video. A very, very long awaited video. I am so sorry that I haven't filmed are uploaded in like 3 weeks, so yeah, because of that I thought I'd do like a life update kind of thing to kind of tell you where I've been and why I've not been uploading. It's not like I had a choice. So yeah, about 3 weeks ago I was planning on filming and uploading, but I had the dentist the same day, and yeah, I'm not the best with the dentist, but you know, yeah. I was having two fillings and he obviously numbed, it was both sides, he numbed both sides of me, and yeah, basically he numbed me and my whole face went numb. So my, like, under my eyes, my mouth, my cheeks, my ears, like everything was numb, which looking back now is just not normal. And when he put the injection in on this side, I had like this kind of like electric shock sensation go through my jaw, and me being me just wanted it over and done with, so I just kind of like didn't say anything and got it over and done with and went home. So by the end of the day, most of the numbing had gone. Bear in mind I had this one at 10:30 in the morning, so normally the numbing goes away like after an hour or so. By the end of the day, most of the numbing had gone apart from this part of my mouth. Which is really weird because like the filling was like down here and it was the front of my mouth that was numb, but yeah. And the only thing I'd ate that day was breakfast, and couldn't really move my jaw, couldn't really do much basically. And yeah, so like I didn't feel up to filming that day because it was still numb. And then yeah, I thought, right, I'll go to sleep and I'll be all good by the next day. The numbing would have gone in asleep and I'll be fine the next day. Woke up the next day, I was still numb. Yay, best thing ever. Yeah, I was still numb, obviously, didn't understand why. Went to work, really poorly at work. Bear in mind that night we were actually going to Covic's tour. I was actually driving to Leeds after work, and work wanted to send me home because I went all hot and yeah, and felt like I was gonna throw up and stuff. And then I refused to go home early because I was like, either way I'm still driving to Leeds, me being me, determined. And yeah, so because I hadn't ate properly since the morning before, I then ended up getting soup for dinner, which I don't even like soup, and like a chocolate mousse and a Lucozade to get my like sugar levels back up because I've not ate. And yeah, and felt better after I'd ate something, so clearly it was just because I've not eaten. And then I planned on filming Covic's tour, I planned on vlogging, but it just wasn't happening because I was still numb. Like this was over 24 hours, still numb, which is not normal. So anyway, went to Leeds, had a really, really amazing time watching Covic. I smashed it as usual. And then I had the next day off, but I was going out for a friend's birthday. So yeah, drove back down to Manchester, was still numb. Woke up the next day, still numb. Still isn't normal, but hey ho, still rocking the numbness. the whole day completely numb, still struggling to eat. Went out, came back home, still numb. Next day, I was going to Newcastle for COVID's tour, and I was still numb. Now, this led me to Googling my symptoms, which obviously don't do because, yeah, but this actually like relaxed me like on what happened. Everybody says don't Google them, but you know, everybody does. So I Googled my symptoms and turns out I have a damaged nerve, which is why I'm still to this day numb. Bear in mind, this was like 2-3 weeks ago. So yeah, still numb. Have a damaged nerve from where he's jabbed the injection in, and it could take up to 6 months to heal itself. So I could be numb for 6 months. Yay. But like everyone has been pointing out, at least I'm not in pain. So that's a good thing. Now, like I was saying, I wanted to vlog COVID tour, didn't end up doing, which is annoying. But yeah, so obviously we went to Leeds, Newcastle, Birmingham, Manchester, Birmingham, London. And by the second to last date in Birmingham, I had completely lost my voice. Yay. So I'm still numb, I've got no voice. And yeah, lost my voice. Went by the next day, we went to London, couldn't speak, feeling ill. Yay. I've just had it all happen like all together. COVID was absolutely amazing. Like they smashed it. They did the first 1,000-cap venue in London and absolutely amazing, had the best time. And the guys were really, really good, and so were the support acts, amazing. So obviously I couldn't vlog any of it, yay. But then I was ill, so that's cool. And then also in London, the support act Corinne also got ill, but not as ill as what I was feeling. And then I was like, I'm so sorry if I've given it you, because obviously she's come all the way from America and she had to travel back. So traveling back ill is not the best thing. So anyway, yeah, COVID tour over, had the best time ever considering I couldn't speak for the last 2 days of it. But they all looked after me amazingly, and yeah. So, COVID tour over and done with. I was still poorly. And this was obviously like 2 weeks ago. No, like week last Thursday. So it would be 2 weeks when you watch this. Poorly me, yeah. But me being me doesn't like to like phone in sick and stuff. So I still went back into work with hardly a voice, full of a cold. And yeah, so that was that. Then, when was it? On Friday. Yeah, so Friday just gone. I was in work and, oh no, I woke up. Oh, Thursday. So last week for you guys, I had this headache appearing like right here. Not the greatest headache, never experienced a headache like it before. Took some ibuprofen, took some paracetamol, luckily it went. And then went to bed. The next morning, it was like between 10 and 11 in the morning. Mum comes in to check up on me, and I had the worst headache I have ever experienced again here. And my mum was asking me if I was okay, and I was like, no offense, mum, but you speaking to me is making it 10 times worse. And she was like, right, okay, well, I'm going shopping. She spoke to the pharmacy doctor person, and they thought it was congested, this cold in my head, and that's what was giving me the headache. So they gave me these tablets I had to take every 4 hours, and I could take them with painkillers, so I took ibuprofen with them. The first lot cleared my headache straight away, which was really good. So then I went to work. The headache came back, took the tablets, wouldn't go. So then I went and spoke to my manager, and then she asked me how I was, and then I burst out crying because this headache wouldn't go and I felt really poorly. And then yeah, I ended up going home, slept, and then yeah, it seems to have gone. The only thing that I can describe now is, like, if you go swimming and you get water up your nose and then it stings like the hole here, so obviously it's my sinuses. But then I found out the other day that this headache is actually a symptom of the flu. So it looks like I've had a touch of the flu as well as this stupid cold that you can probably still hear in my voice because I've still got it. But yeah, that is where I have been. I've been poorly, I've had traumatic times. Yay. So that is why I've not uploaded, I've not filmed, but I am back because I'm feeling more myself, which is really good. So I'm back, I'm better than ever, and yeah, I just wanted to say I'm so sorry I've not uploaded, but as you can hear from my traumatic experiences, I have been poorly. And I am still numb, but I can cope with that. Like, I'd rather be numb than be in pain. And I think this cold is going, I feel more human anyway, so it's all good. But yeah, I just wanted to say I'm so sorry I've not uploaded, but I'm back. I'm back. And I'm going to try and continue to do weekly videos for you guys. But yeah, I'm back. Back, better than ever. And I struggle to do my makeup nowadays now that this is numb because I can't even feel it. So I'm hopefully going to be uploading weekly again, but obviously I've not really like planned out any videos, so if anybody has any suggestions on what I should film, like if you want a little highlights video from COVID tour again, please let me know, because I do have, like, my sister basically videos every single bit of the COVID gig, and yeah, there's always like special moments in there and stuff like that. So if you would like me to film another highlights gig, like highlights moment, that'd be cool. Like, I'd love that. Or yeah, any suggestions, just let me know. And I am going to be back filming, so it's going to be amazing. And yeah, like, I'm happy I'm back. Like, I've missed filming and editing and uploading and YouTube. Yeah, and going on a trip soon, so I'll be vlogging. Yeah, just wanted to say I'm sorry I'm not uploaded, and I am back. And yeah, just wanted to kind of explain, kind of give you like a life update. And yeah, so sorry I've not uploaded, but I'm back. I am back, back again. Sarah's back. Tell a friend. Yeah, so thought I'd just let you know. And yeah, so again, sorry I've not uploaded, but I am back better than ever, and I will be uploading weekly, hopefully. So yeah, anyway, I'm going to stop rambling and go. And yeah, just let me know if you've got any suggestions on what I should do. I might do the COVID highlight thing, because why not? Cool. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, and yeah, I will 100% see you next week with a new video. Bye! I don't know where the camera thing is in here. I can't do it. Right, so that's gonna fail because, like, my camera's dead and I don't know where the thing is on my iPhone. Yeah, peace, see you later, bye. I'm just gonna do that. Bye!